But
man, you can make the what is that?
Hold on, did you guys see that? Everybody, GrayStillPlays, and we're back with more My Summer Insomnia. No time for BS. Normally, I would pee right now, but I'm not going. This is interesting. I left the truck here when I got off the game, and it looks like the yellow car almost spawned right inside of it. I would love to knock the yellow car over and then give it the finger and stuff, but we have to get home, like, epically fast. Look at the fatigue bar. This is what we in the My Summer Car world call, air quotes, a bad thing. We can very easily die from a heart attack, and I don't want that, because that would make me sad. Oh, come on, glow plugs, get done already. There we go. No, I have time for this bullshit. Okay, let's get out of here as fast as we can. Throw it in reverse. Even if the yellow car is behind us, I'm gonna slam right through it. Screw you, yellow car. I think we dragged it around a little bit. I don't know, maybe we did, maybe we didn't. Let's get the crap out of here. Whoa, thirst is fucking up big time here too. Grab a beer real quick, kind of hang on over to grab one. Both the beer and the fatigue going down, and because the thirst was down so much, I ended up drinking a beer real early in the series right now. I think to get home, I'm gonna make a right over here and go just as fast as I can. Hopefully no one's coming, because I'm going right out into traffic. I could care less. Right out into traffic. Nope, no one's coming. We probably need to turn our lights on too. Oh God, come on, there we go. All right, the nighttime is coming. You could tell from, in this game, it's like barking dogs and the cuckoo, little cuckoo starts cuckooing around, and there you have you when it's time. We're gonna be moving here. We're gonna be passing past Lope. We're gonna need to go past there. And then the second right-hand turn that we can make is gonna be the turn to get home. But holy crap, guys, we are gonna be scraping the barrel really, really close, because the fatigue is real. And after we do that, there's a couple things I wanna do. First off, we need to drop our car off to get the roll cage done. Someone brought up a very good point, because I cannot math well enough. And we get 50% off, I think, for the roll cage, I'm pretty sure. So our 5,500 marks that it costs will only be 2,250 marked. Yeah, like I just said, I can math. So we're gonna be just fine when it comes to the money. Now, we're over 100 kilometers per hour right now, which in this thing is very, very fast, especially when we don't have the rear end down. But after I saw the gas savings in not having the rear end down, I'm gonna keep it up as much as I can. I can drive well enough without it down. I can stay on the road, let me put it that way. I've gotten to the point where my skill at driving the shipmobile is as such that should I need to do evasive maneuvers to keep myself alive, I can. I don't like, our lights are not bright enough. Is there like a high beam or something? There we go, that looks a lot better. We'll just be an asshole when we're coming up upon people. It's weird, you drift in this thing. Like, okay, so right now, like right there, I just hit the right, and look how we're drifting. Like, we're not even really doing like a true turn, like right here, but we're like drifting down the roadway. It's something you get used to after you drive it for a while. Well, let me go around this thing over here. You do not want to hit that truck, man. That'll be the end of you right there. So, right over here, passing our very first town, again, over 100 kilometers per hour, you start to lose a lot of traction. Over 110 kilometers per hour in this thing. So if you want to stay alive, good, stay below this. But our fatigue is scaring the shit out of me. So I just want to get home as quick as possible. Oh, some folks were asking about giving the yellow thump thump car the middle finger while it was upside down. I've done that after we flipped it with the hammer. I've done that, it really doesn't do anything. It just spins its tires, because there's nothing it can do. It doesn't have any traction or anything. It can't go anywhere. So all it does is just spin its tires while laying on its back like a turtle that got owned. I'm not sure how much time you have when your fatigue is in the red before you die. I think it's like right around 10 minutes or so from what I've seen. Just from like kind of some of the stuff I've done, I feel like that's appropriate. I don't want to go too off-road here, because like I said, I died one time going off-road. Go ahead and throw the gears down a little bit here so we can get a bit more power going up this hill. I could switch to low gear, but it's kind of a pain in the ass. Once we go around here, we're gonna make a left and then a right. Someone said, and I didn't know this, but someone had said that the sun, or I don't know the sun, but it stays light out at night over in Finland? Is that like all year round or just part of the year or what? That is crazy. I know that happens up in Alaska, and someone had said that the longitudinal position of Finland is equal to Anchorage, Alaska, I think it was. Is that true? I guess I could Google it if I had to, but I like getting the opportunity to ask you guys questions and just kind of interact with you every once in a while. So, now the holidays are over, I've got a little bit more time. I'm starting to get to some of the comments. Obviously, I can't get to them all. I try and get to quite a few of them. I also try and reply to people on Twitter as much as I can. Obviously, between all the comments and Twitters and tweets and twats and everything else, and PMs and emails and everything, I get hundreds and hundreds a day, and I love every single one of them because I love you guys. But sometimes I can't get all the responses I want to get in. Just know that I'm thinking about you constantly. That's enough sappy stuff. Our fatigue still in the red. It's not getting any better, man. I gotta push as hard as I can because having a heart attack right now would be a pain in the balls. The only good thing is that if we did have a heart attack, I've memorized this entire map by now. I know where everything is on this map for the most part. So I know where we are. We're very close to home. So the big rig would probably just sit here in the middle of nowhere. We would have to hitchhike our way home, which would suck ass because I have more important things that I want to do. But we would be able to find the big rig pretty easy. Someone had said they downloaded, back in episode 17, I have my save file sitting in a pinned comment. If you want like my save file at the time over there, maybe I'll post a newer save file with what we've got right now. But they were saying, where is the tractor and the log trailer? It was over by the wood cutting place. I had left it there because I drag it with this. And at that time, I had dragged it over there and I never brought it back. I just hadn't brought it back at the time, so it was still just sitting there. In fact, it's there now. And this, as of this episode right now, it is still there. Because I usually drop it off there, and then when I get done, I go and do sewage jobs and stuff. Oh my god, there's our house. We're almost there. Please do not have a heart attack right now. I would feel like such a dick. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Oh, we're going in. We're going buck wild right here. We're going in full speed. Come on. Come on, come on, come on, go, 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 go. Okay. Right about here, the dog is a barking. Screw you, park and brake on, turn this BS off. Jump on out. Someone said you could headbutt and sleep. Let's freaking do that. Bam. Yes. Talk about cheating like a bitch. Oh, that's what I'm talking about, baby. Oh, our hunger and thirst is super high right now. But we've got... Is this new? Hold on, was this poster here before? I thought it was a different poster. Whoa! All right, hold on. I'm gonna get that in a second. Let's go have a real quick thing of milk, because milk gets you both hunger and thirst. Get out of here, man. There we go. What do you got here? Oh my god, it's the super creepy guy. Yes, your sewage well, full of crap. Got it. Our sauna is still on too. What's the time right now? 6 a.m. perhaps? Do you guys do saunas in the morning, the evening, or whenever you like? Because, I don't know, like, you know, over here in the United States, pretty much, I would say people shower whenever they feel like it. Some people shower at night, some people shower in the day. So, it's kind of a whatever feels natural for you. I personally do it at night, just because that's when time permits the best for me. Go ahead and get that going. We are, how are we doing on beer, man? All right, we got a couple of beers in here. We got three cases of beer, but two of them are half empty right now, which is good. That lets you know the house has been lived in. I'm just going to finish headbutt my way through here. Drop that on down. I don't know why, I just felt like doing that. I also got to remember to use the jump button because that's how you can stand up should you need to. I just never end up using it that much. I'm going to put the water on this shelf today. I never do that. Let's go ahead and get clean. We might as well, right? Whoop-wah! That was a total miss. Crap. Come here, beer. Come here, beer. Beer. Beer, what are you doing? What are you doing, beer? Why is this not working? What? Oh, you son of a bitch. Hold on, let me drop this. There. Get up. There we go. I could have sworn that I was having an easier time drinking beers while simultaneously using the sauna last time. I don't know, maybe it's just me. Holy crap, talk about bad aim. There we go. There we are. Now we're catching beers. I really don't know what happened. Holy crap, our urine is getting super high too. Try and get some of this dirtiness down. Dirtiness is moving by itself at this point. Things are looking very, very good. Since we didn't start the game off with a nice long piss, we're going to finish one off here in just a second. All right, let's get the hell down here. All right, one more beer. I'll do one more beer for you guys. Let's get down here, open this door up. Can I hit the door while I'm doing this? There we go. And right up in here, oh crap, I left the refrigerator open. What am I cooling the whole house down? That's what Mom used to say back in the day. And here, this is gonna be a good one, guys. Here we go. Oh man, I got it. I know you guys know those times where like you're trying to drive home or whatever, and it's like, you can pull off on the side of the road, but you just want to get to the sanctity of the porcelain here before you let her loose. And when you finally get there, the sensation that washes over you is like sweet ambrosia. It is bliss times a million, and boom, there we go. So, the beer situation. Dude, what is this? More lights? Aren't the lights in the car? Hold on a second here. Wait a minute. Oh, the lights are in the car. Are they out in the car? That's odd. No, they're in the car. We have a second set of Christmas lights. Did we get two sets of Christmas lights? Those are one for the front and the back? I don't know. No, whatever. Anywho. Let me go ahead and go over here. I'm going to turn this off. I know some people keep it running all the time. That's not what I want to do. I know some people keep it running all the time, but I feel weird. I feel like it's a bad waste of energy. I know, I have certain peculiarities, homo hyperclean, certain peculiarities that only crop up in certain situations, and that's kind of one of them. You know what, let's go ahead and bug spray ourselves real fast, too. Screw you, mosquitoes. I've got extremely overpriced mosquito repellent. I don't know how much, I don't know if mosquito repellent is known as something very expensive for you guys over in Finland, but it certainly seemed that way when I went into the, when I went into the store to do my thing with it. Let me see if I can get this inside the garbage here. No, I think that went behind the garbage. Hold on, one more time. Oh shit, are we out of beer in here? This is bad. I know, my bumper's still on the ground. This is bad. Hold on. Let me get up in here real quick. We got a long way to run. We got a long way to run, guys. I don't think we're gonna make it. Hold on. Running jump. Crap, what did it hit? It's like it hit some sort of level inside of the scene here. Some sort of existential barrier that we can't get past. Anyhow, what we've got to do is I'm going to have to hook the car up to the shipmobile so we can drag this thing over to Flattari's shop, because I don't know how long it's going to take for him to get this thing in. I would assume 24 hours. And this car is at that shop for the reason of when you drop your car off, you have a way to get home. I don't think that there's any other way to get home. I mean, I'm not 100% sure, but I'm pretty sure there's not. I will put the other seat in. Don't worry. Let's go ahead and get this done first, though. Go ahead and jump right in here. Literally jump right in here. Oh, yeah. We got the lights going right up in here. Looking good. Go ahead and back up. We're a little bit wobbly. Actually, we're a lot wobbly right now. Oh shit, I almost punched my own windshield out. That's what you don't want to do. But old Gray does it all the time. I punched so many windshields out, you guys don't even know. Alright, we need to get, like, pretty well up in here. You want to stay real close. Real close. In fact, I'm gonna like, nudge it. There we go. Right there. Good. Okay, put her in neutral. No big deal. Do not put the parking brake on. The parking brake's not on, right? Okay, good. It looked like it was on almost for a second there. I'm going to keep all the beer and sausage in here. No big deal. Now, the other thing that I want to do while we're out, while we're dragging this thing with this, is I want to see if we can knock any other vehicles out with our hammer. So if we come across any police or anything, we are going to give them the freaking heave-ho big time. Toe hook right there, keeping it legit. You know how it is. Let's go ahead and close our door real quick. You know what? I'm going to take this with us. Well, I'm going to put it in the car. I'm going to take this with us just in case we need it for some reason. I don't know why I would, but you never know, man. Go ahead and put that over there. Now, if we keep this nice and close to our big rig, it shouldn't be flip-flopping all around. Because let me tell you something. I don't know if you guys remember the episode I did where we were trying to do as much damage to the car as possible. We did not have it close to the vehicle. Because the further you go from the vehicle, that's interesting, the glow plugs are still good. The further you have it from the vehicle, the crazier flips and shit it'll do. And let me tell you, it'll do some flips and shit. It was going all over the place. I'm gonna do a nice wide turn this way. Right over here. Alright, looks like we're dragging it pretty good. This is weird. Are you guys noticing that the paint job has turned white inside of our side view mirror here? Or maybe it's just because of the reflections? Oh, let me turn my lights off too. Go hit it in reverse here. And then hopefully we're not doing a ton of damage to this thing while we're doing this. I think that my hood is on most of the way. Now, you could probably drive this thing real, real careful like, but screw that, says old Gray. We're gonna try and get there ASAP. After all, we're heading to the shop anyway, right, guys? While we're out, we could always, well, let me think. We could probably pick up the wood chipping thingamajew, the tractor, and, oh God, what was that? Hold on. Son of a bitch, hold on 1 second, guys. All right, front bumper came off. Nothing I didn't expect. We'll just throw that right back in there, no big deal. If it's just a bumper, I could care less. Honestly, the bumpers are a little bit too chromed out for the current paint job. A lot of you guys like this paint job. I think it looks pretty damn cool too. So, good, thank you to the one that made it. You did an excellent job. Looks very, very cool. I know I saw your comment. I think I replied? I don't know. If I didn't, then I'm replying now. Thank you much. Oh God. Oh shit. I went over a hill and the car kind of went on its side. It still looks like it's in one piece. I think I'm gonna have to drive a little bit slower though, because it straight up freaking bounced like a basketball. Oh God. This is the part of the game I hate the most, is trying to slowly inch this poor bastard over to the shop. I am not gonna take the off-road way to the shop. I'm gonna take the road, the highway to the shop, because it's a little bit longer to go the highway way, but quite honestly, these back roads, this car on these back roads towing it, it's just a bad idea. Unless you are a very, very safe driver, and those of you that have been with me for a while, well, you know I'm not. Shit, we just lost something else. All right, what came off the fucking car this time? Oh, there's something laying on the ground. What is that? What is this? What the hell is this? Oh, it's a fender. Random fender. Fender left. Oh, you know what? This gives us an opportunity to try something. I don't think I want to do it quite yet. Someone said, though, if you put, like, the fender underneath one of the wheels, the car goes flying. Oh, we lost both fenders. Oh, it's because the freaking, I don't know what to call this, like, the rear tow area of our freaking tanker is deep inside of the vehicle. Let's go ahead and throw this in here as well. There we go. We've got one fender right there. And I'll put the other fender. Oh, Jesus Christ. Put the other fender in here as well. There we go. Everything's nice and nice inside now. The hood's still on though. Pretty happy about that. Didn't miss anything else, did we? All right, everything looks okay. Wow, it is like right in the engine bay. Lucky for us, I don't think that the game is that accurate to when there's that bar sitting in the engine bay. It basically destroys the vehicle like that. Let's continue onward. Oh shit, here we go. Don't you hit my fucking car. Whoa, something else just popped off. You know what, man? This is some bullshit. This car is literally falling apart while I'm trying to get it from point A to point B. Oh shit, the hood came off. Can the hood fit inside of here? I don't know. Oh God. Hold on, let me see if I can do this without like getting, hold on. If I can do this without getting the seat all jacked up. Yeah, it fit. Okay, very good. Continuing onward, there's almost nothing left of the vehicle at this point. All of, well, there's plenty left of it, but all the exterior pieces are kind of falling apart. All right, boys, we've almost made it to the roadway here. Let me go ahead and look both ways. This is one of those instances where I definitely don't want to pull out in front of traffic with our car. I don't care so much about the, see right there. That's why you gotta watch. I don't care so much about the tanker because I'm pretty sure that you still can't do damage to the tanker for the most part. But I definitely don't want to get the Satsuma in like a head-on collision with one of these freaking vehicles. Plus, one of the things that we learned in another episode was that the tow rope has no limit to its tensile strength. It doesn't matter if something hits the thing that you're towing at 100 kilometers per hour and you're moving at 100 kilometers per hour. We actually did that. There was the other tanker that runs around the map. We did a head-on with it, but we swung around so that the Satsuma that we were pulling got caught on it. And oh my god, it was like a freaking bola being thrown, if you guys know what a bola is. Oh, here comes an accident! Bam! We almost got wiped out right there. That would have sucked. But anyway, our two vehicles got like chained together thanks to the tethering of the vehicle, and we were flipping and flopping all over the place. This thing must have rolled like 5 or 6 or 7 times. The vehicle was toast. The Satsuma had every piece of damage done to it you could possibly have. It looked like it had went through a fucking volcano or something. And it was just bad. It was just bad all around, and it's not something I would suggest unless you have your save backed up and you just want to see how much damage you can levy on the car. We got a couple cars here. What is this? Two white cars. I've never seen cars so close together. That was interesting. Kind of wonder if the traffic AI has been modified at all. I know they mentioned that the AI of the vehicles had been modified in some way. I'm just not exactly sure how. Okay, we made it here. Let's go ahead and start slowing down a wee bit as we kind of get ready to make our left into the area of the shop. Oh, yeah, there we go. Car, it's probably seen better days, but I don't, oh shit. Oh God, this is not what you want to do. You don't want to be bouncing like this. Next thing you know, the thing goes on its side. We got all kinds of beer and sausage sitting inside the car too, so I'd really rather not lose it all. All right, I think we're doing all right now. Right over here. Go ahead and pull on up, roll on up, so to speak. Not a lot of space for us to pull on up though. I think we can get right through this here pocket though. Let me go ahead and try here. Right through here. My Tetris foo isn't too bad. Right about there. All right, go ahead and hit the brake. Turn things off. Still got, what do we have, a half tank of gas? Yeah, man, I'll tell you what, baby. You've gotta turn that stuff off. You gotta turn that axle off if you can drive without it, because holy crap, it helps. Where'd my freaking toe right there? There we go. So there's the vehicle. I think it's got a little bit of damage, but we made it. All right, buddy. I got some stuff I want to buy from you. What's going on in my mind? I'll tell you right now, baby. I want a roll cage installation. And what else? What else can I afford? An engine adjustment, hey? I wonder about that. An engine adjustment. Oh, people said just get the wheels aligned here, and I think we're gonna go ahead and do that. I mean, it only comes out to like 200 and something because we get the half price. So let's do that. What else can we do? Motor tuning. We're not gonna have a ton of cash left over here. Blah 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 blah. Final gear change. Which one of these is best for rallying, guys? Maybe we'll do that at some point. Body, sheet metal, and rust repair. I'm not gonna worry about that right now. Custom paint, we've already got that. Metal color, nope, we don't have to worry about that at all. And rim polish. Rim polish, huh? Rim painting. Well, you can paint the rims. We've done it. Unless there's something special that you can do here. All right, let's do that for right now, I think. Yeah, we'll do that for right now. Take my Ferndale. Well, I've already taken a Ferndale, baby. Ferndale belongs to me. All right, let's go ahead. And is there anything in here that I know I'm going to need? You know what? Let's grab a sausage real quick because we're pretty hungry. And we might as well grab a sausage since it's laying in there. Let's go grab our vehicle, see if we can find some traffic and try and fuck them up with the hammer. Alrighty. Here we are out by the highway. I think I'm just going to go ahead and park the old truck right over here, so to speak. Go ahead and throw it on there. Go ahead and grab the hammer. Oh, hold on. We got a vehicle coming right now. Oh, come on. Gotta get out there in time. Oh, we're not gonna make it. You son of a bitch! Damn it! I wanted to try and hammer it. All right. Well, I'm gonna sit out here for a little bit. I'm just gonna put the old hammer down right there for right now. Got a nice case of beer out here with us, so we can go ahead and get one of these going on. And this is it, man. This is the new Finnish sport. It's called Finnish car flipping. We don't have any way to defend ourselves other than the hammer. But as we all know, in the realm of rock, paper, scissors, hammer beats everything. Go ahead and grab this like this. Kind of turn it this way. All right, let's try this out here. Where's this red car kind of at? All right, it's right about here. Go ahead and see what this hammer does. Here, right here. Whoa, I think it worked. Hold on. It's stopping. We just need to catch up to it. Don't you go anywhere yet, buddy. Don't you go anywhere yet, you son of a bitch. Hold on. Yes. Hold on. Yeah! Yes! All right. One car down. Who's next? Who else wants to take the hammer? Oh, what do we got going on over here? All right. Hold on. Let me get down low. Down low. Bam! Right there. Another man down. Just got to catch him now. We're gonna cause some shit here, guys. Don't you go anywhere yet. Don't you go anywhere. I'm coming, baby. I'm coming for you. I love how they stop as if to say, like, you talking to me? Whoa, holy shit. I almost got taken out. All right, here we go. Here we go. Lift her up. Yeah. Did a barrel roll there, baby. Oh, look at this car. I don't think I remember ever seeing this car before with the green doors. Hold on. Go ahead and get you all flipped up and over. There we go. And now you, good sir, you're next. Hold on, let me get you up here. Get you up. Do a full roll. Yeah, you should have known better. Oh, we got someone incoming, guys. Here we go. We've created a hell of a thing here. Wah-bah-bah-bah! Yes! Oh, yes! Hold on. Who would have thought this would be so much fun? All right, let me see if I can flip this. Oh, hold on, we missed. Get this one more here, right about here. Let me see if I can flip it on top of the other one. Ha! Okay, just kind of missed. Now, there we go, now we're getting it. Come on, flip for Gray. Yeah! And you too, you freaking dirtbag. Whoa, I wonder if I could just flip you this way. There we go. Yeah, just kind of nudge him over. Like, whoa. Look at that. You gotta get them all the way over, otherwise they recover. Damn! Look at that! Doing full rolls on this guy. Come on, get all the way over. All the way over. There we go. Okay. Oh shit. Oh god. Well, let me get out of the way here. Whoa! Yes! Oh my god, can we make this thing fly? Isn't this the beer truck? Hold on, I need to know. Oh, no, don't go yet. Don't go. Don't you go anywhere yet. Hold on. Do not move, beer truck. Do not move. Okay. Oh, yes. Yes! Oh, it's so hard to flip, though, because there's so much stuff. Come on. We gotta get it over. Or at least we gotta move it to the middle of the road. Oh, I don't know if it's... Oh, look at our hammer flipping out! Oh, wow. We can get it moving all crazy-like, though. Holy shit, this hammer is so awesome. All right, hold on. Let me see. I wanna get a bigger accident going. Let me see if I can push this. Yep, sure can. Kind of push it this way here. There we go. Push that like that. Straighten it out a little bit. Hold on a second, guys, while I get this set up. Whoa! Oh, shit! Oh, we almost died big time right there. Oh, I missed the van! Yes! Oh, the van ran into that freaking red car right over there. Hold on, let me see if I can get the van all flipped over. At that point, we will have flipped most of the vehicle. Oh no, the van's running away! Oh wait, it's gonna hit that white car. Oh wait, maybe it's not. Hold on. Ah! Damn it! Wow, the van can really take some damage. Look at how messed up it is. Hold on. Go ahead and get down low. Get down low for the van! Yeah! That's how you do it, baby. That is how you do it. All right. Well, I think we've, wow. I think we've created quite a bit of destruction. The only other thing I'd want to do is, hold on, let me see if I can line everything up to get like a big pile up going. Hold on. All right, we've got the potential for a fairly decent pile up to start here. I've got these two cars over here now. I wonder if I can get this other red car in on the action. Oh, this is looking good. All we need is we need something to go flying through down here. I think that, I'm not really sure which way. Where's the green thump car when you need him? I want him going down the highway here. That would be absolutely insane if he went through here. But I'm getting pretty good at car flipping, man. I tell you what, watch this right here. We can scoop him up like this. Just kind of flip him like that there. Oh, that is good. That is friggin' rich. Then we can kind of make him go like this. See that right there? You just kind of push him. Push him around like this. Oh, this hammer is a friggin'... This hammer is pure gold. I can't... This is so funny. I love this hammer so much. I'm glad I found this. How we looking? Looking pretty good. See if I can just push it over a little bit more to where the other vehicles are. And then we just got to get it flipped over. All right, that looks good right about there. Get nice and low so we can get underneath the rear. And then, oh shit, hold on. A little bit more like this. There we go. Now flip it like that there. Whoa, we're making it slide all over the place. All right, that looks pretty good. Go ahead and let me see if I can push it lightly. We'll push it lightly out into the roadway. Ah, shitty, flip back over. All right, boys, here we go. Here we go. Yes! Oh, man, there we go. Nice four-car crash right there. I tried to, what the fuck is this? There's a skid mark in midair. What sort of sorcery is going on here? All right, I think we've caused enough havoc for right now. That was cool, though. So the hammer is a very, very fun toy to play with. And yes, if I come across the police, we will definitely check out to see how much we can mess with them. I imagine they would react just like the rest of these vehicles. They would probably just do all kinds of flips and stuff like that. You can't kill anyone inside, but
man, you can make the... What is that?
Hold on, did you guys see that? It was like God's hand came down and tossed that freaking van through the air. Oh my God, where did it go off the map? I wish I was facing that when it happened. Here it is. Here's the van right over here. You can see it through the brush. I have no idea what happened to that van, but that was absolutely amazing. That was so cool. All right, guys, that's gonna be it for now. We're gonna get our rally car done, and then we're gonna do a little bit of rallying next time. Every once in a while, though, I gotta just dick around for a little bit. Until the next time, folks, stay foxy and much love.